Hi, welcome to another OpenTap Lightning video. In the last video, we saw how to set up the built-in result listeners in OpenTap. In this video, we are going to be looking at how to generate and publish results that go into those result listeners from our test steps. So let's get started. In OpenTap, a result is something that has a name and a value associated with it. The result source class is part of the OpenTap SDK and it provides us with mechanisms to publish these results. Each test step contains a public property of type result source that allow us to use these methods. Let's take a look at some examples. In this first example, we are using the publish API to publish a result called myResultTable with a single value representing pi. Let us look at how this is represented in a CSV file. Here, you can see that you have the step name followed by the step duration and then the result name and the value. Let's look at how to publish an array of results. In this example, I have a set of name value pairs. I have a list of all my names. I have another list that contains the corresponding values. I can use the results.publish call to publish this array of results. If you take a look at the CSV file, you can see all the name value pairs have been written. If you have your result data contained in a class, you can use the results.publish API directly without having to modify it. In this example, we have a class called measurementData that contains a set of properties that we want to publish. We can use the publish API to directly send these data out. The CSV file contains all of their properties and the corresponding values. Next, let's see how to publish an entire table containing a large number of results. The results class contains a publish table method that can be used for publishing multiple values. Here, you see that we use the publish table method to publish the data that contains several rows. This is the recommended way of publishing large amount of data. If you want to defer the results publishing to a later time, then you can use the defer method available on the result source class. This is useful in cases where you want your test plan execution to continue without having to wait for the processing of results. So in this video, we learned about various result publishing mechanisms that are there in OpenTap. We looked at how to publish a single name value pair, an array of values, a custom data set, as well as large table data. We also looked at how to use the defer method to defer the publishing of results to a later time. Remember that you can always refer to the working examples in the example solution. Thank you for watching and see you again in another video.